As Election Day approaches, the jam continues to meet the candidates running for the mayor of Chicago. Today, we're joined by Bob Fioretti, who was born and raised in Chicago and is now a civil rights attorney and former alderman of the 2nd Ward. Hello and welcome.
Good to be here. Thank you.
Thank you. So this is your second time running for mayor. What's different about this time?
Well, I'm running again because the issues I raised before and I ran for alderman to solve problems, but the problems are worse here now in the city of Chicago. Crime, education, bad budgeting, the pension problem that's going to envelope everything. I'm running to solve the problems that face the people of this city, the working people, and to make sure that we have an all-inclusive mayoral office.
So what do you mean by this statement you recently made that we need structural change and not cosmetic change? What are you specifically referring to?
Well, I think up and down we need a new government. City governments failed its citizens. We need a smaller city council. We need term limits. We need a budget process that reaches out to the people that they're involved in the process. I'm going to have town hall meetings throughout the city on the budgets, and I'm going to go to every ward and have ward night. We need to listen to our people. They've got good solutions, good answers to the problems that face this city.
Okay, we know 410 people murdered with guns just last year. What would be your plan to tackle crime? That's a concern that I think affects every Chicagoan.
Well, you know, it's surprising. All of a sudden, these candidates are adopting the views that I had. When I had a killing of a young boy down at Crane High School, we flooded it with social services. I was one of the architects that created Operation Safe Passage. You know, we have to reopen our mental health clinics. Yes, we need more police officers. We need more detectives. But, you know, we need people to work with our police and trust our police, and together we'll solve the problem.
Well, that was a big deal when the mental health clinics closed down a couple years ago, specifically on the south and west sides of the city. What will you do to help bring those back or to bring some new resources?
Well, it's minimal to reopen them. I think anybody that drives under a viaduct, under Wacker Drive, sees all the homeless. Up along the Dan Ryan Expressway, you see hundreds of tents right now. Mm-hmm. Mental illness should never be criminalized, but we need to help those people, and they commit small crimes sometimes. Together, we can work it and solve the problems, and I think opening mental health clinics is one of the keys.
Okay, the teachers union, they just came out yesterday asking for a 5% increase in pay, and they're also asking for smaller class sizes, and they're saying that corporations should be the one to pay for it. What would be your response to this?
Well, you know, I think we have to look at where we can consolidate, what we need to do. Teachers deserve fair pay. Our teachers work hard. There's a big difference between some of the schools and what happens, but, you know, I don't think taxing all of the people in this city. They said, let's deal with the tax on the corporations, tax the rich. Well, the rich are going to leave the city. They're the ones that create the small jobs. So we have to be wise in what we do. We've got to be firm. We've got to work together. But it's not all for me. As the teachers union yesterday said, me, me, me. No, we've got other problems across the city. So we've got to work collaboratively together to solve the problem.
What's your stance on our alternative funding like a casino or the legalization of marijuana?
In 2010, I came out in favor of a casino. We should have one. All that money should go into the pension fund. Legalizing marijuana and taxing it will only give us a very small amount, the studies have shown. And I've been in favor of legalizing and taxing it since I took office over 10 years ago.
Okay. And as we're still talking education, you mentioned that you were for term limits for being mayor for the
mayor and city council.
And city council.
Yes, and
okay.
A smaller city council. I mean, out of the 10 largest cities in the United States, we have one of the largest city councils, only two cities don't have term limits, Chicago and Philadelphia.
Okay. What about the school board? I have to wrap. But do you think we need an elected school
board?
I've
always been in favor of an elected school board.
Okay. All right. Thank you for your time. We certainly appreciate it. And good luck to you in the mayor's race.
And good for all the energy here, too.
Thank you. We hope you'll come back and visit us.
Yes.
So please remember the Chicago mayoral election is February 26th. The Jam, we got you covered. As always, we are interviewing a number of other mayoral candidates. We've interviewed a lot. So head to thejamtvshow.com to get better informed before you head to the polls.